Color management. We only have sufficient room on the DVD to scratch the surface. Actually, we would need a complete new DVD just to explain you the ins and outs of color management. But in our manual, there are a few pages which are very enlightening. And in this part, we're going to talk about how to use color management in EasySign. So we're going to talk mainly about the uses of it and some few advantages. We open a worksheet, color_01.es. You can find it in the project files folder on the root of the DVD in the subfolder ES. On the top row of the worksheet, you see a CMYK bitmap and vectors with a CMYK fill. And at the bottom row, an RGB bitmap and vectors with an RGB fill. We're first going to talk about some settings. In the general settings, you can find color management. These options will make sure that every new document has color management enabled and RGB SCMYK managed. You can choose which monitor color profile you want to use, the system monitor profile. The current profile will be specified behind the text. Or use the following profile. You can choose your own profile. Or use the profile that was delivered with EasySign. And you can choose for bitmap import which policy to use. Use document defaults. This is also the default. Or prompt user. Every time a bitmap is important, the user gets a message box. So you get a message box asking you what to do. Or you could say no bitmap should ever be color managed. Or you could say use embedded profile. Color management output. Export vector colors as they are. When this option is off, they get exported as they are. So RGB will be exported as RGB, CMYK as CMYK. If you enable this option, you can choose yourself if all elements should be converted to either color space. And the same option you have for printing to PostScript printers or printing to the print server. The main purpose of color management is to make sure that what you see on your screen will be a closest match as possible to what you get on your output. So if you print this to a desktop printer, it will look almost the same as on your screen. It's also the quality of your screen is very important. So some deviation may occur. And if you put color management off, to reach color management for a document, select with the right mouse button your worksheet, click color management. If enable color management is put off, you can see a totally different view in your worksheet. RGB vector and CMYK vector looks almost the same, or better said, they are exactly identical. CMYK bitmap and RGB bitmap, you can see that CMYK has very bright cyan here and a very harsh line between the lighter part and the darker part, and RGB has a very gradient fill. There's no harsh line between different colors. But if you would print it, it would look like this. RGB always has a much higher gamut than CMYK. This means that in RGB you can define more colors than in CMYK, but a CMYK bitmap will match more closely to your printer because the inks on current printers do not have the gamut to print RGB bitmaps. However, the latest inks match it very close. There probably will come a time when you can design everything, at least for large format color printers and desktop printers, in RGB, but we're not there yet. You have very much control, or very large control, over how your screen representation matches your printer. You can choose from a lot of different ICM and ICC profiles. Every profile that is available on your system will be available in this box. If you see an icon like this, they are placed in the EasySign, in one of the EasySign subfolders, the shared folder to be precise. And if you see an icon like this, this is a system file. So if you have, for example, Photoshop installed on your system and you want to make sure the representation of EasySign matches that of Photoshop very closely, you can choose different profiles, or better said, the same as Photoshop users. And if you watch the screen, you could see there are different differences in how they are displayed. The best thing to do is, mostly you're working on one, two, and in some rare cases more printers, is to experiment which color profile matches the output of your printer the best. The button reset resets it to the default settings. We're going to make a new worksheet. Color management is not only for matching your printer's output, but also for detecting mistakes. If you look on the screen, you can see a very gray area here. This would be exactly what you see on your print. The colors may deviate a little bit, but you definitely would get a gray, ugly area. Here it's nice and blue, here it's nice and black, and here you get an ugly gray. To fix this, the only thing you have to do in case of gradients is to make sure that your end color or from color matches your to or from color. And in this case, the end color is cyan, or from color if you want to be precise. Make sure that the black also has cyan in it. If you look now, these two are totally different. This one will come out very nicely on your printer. This one has the gray area. If you would not have had color management on, first of all, these colors can't be reproduced on any printer. This part can, this part cannot. But as you can see no difference between those two. Color management will make it clear before your print. So if you want to design in without color management, that's no problem. But make sure before you output it that you at least once had color management on, so you can detect mistakes and misinterpretations of color. If you change this color to say from black to yellow. You can even see it better. Very ugly gray. At least it doesn't belong in a gradient fill from black to yellow. And if you take the trouble to mix a little of the other color in the start color, you can see you have a very nice gradient fill. Even from such two completely different colors as yellow and black.